What's that drink they got over there at Johnson's?
Probably something for yuppies.
I don't think so.
Well, it's sure not something for the local boys. might be a geriatric product. Or an elixir for your love life, Morris.
Morris?
Veryfine. Great tasting fruit juices and drinks.
Wesley stands trial for a fatal air crash.
What is your explanation, Mr. Crusher?
I have none.
And finds himself in a desperate cover-up.
Don't try to protect me.
His Starfleet career is going down in flames.
Either you come forward and tell Admiral Brand what really took place, or I will.
How far will he go to hide the truth?
There's no evidence, so there's no case. I can't call Captain Picard a liar.
Next time on Star Trek The Next Generation.
Saturday night at 7.
Cosby, tonight at 9:30.
Closed caption funding provided by Bull Worldwide Information Systems.
A highly charged courthouse in Haverhill this morning greets Irwin Hartford, accused of killing 13-year-old P.J. Davis. George Bush says he's tired of the beating he's taking from the Democrats and will be fighting back. And Meryl Streep, Goldie Hawn, and Bruce Willis team up in the hilarious comedy Death Becomes Her.
Chet Curtis, Natalie Jacobson, Mike Lynch, and Dick Albert, bringing a world of news to New England. This is News Center 5 at 6.
Good evening. The security was intense, the crowd angry today, as accused murderer Irwin Hartford was led into court.
Hartford was found competent to stand trial for the murder of a 13-year-old Haverhill boy. But News Center 5's Jack Harper reports it became obvious today that Hartford's history of mental problems will play a major role as the case moves closer to trial.